Blessed and happy Tuesday to all of you, my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, my dear good people of God, faithful followers of the Daily Gospel Reflection with Father Jack. My dear kababayan, today is May 7, 2024, and today is Tuesday within the sixth week of Easter Year B. Our Gospel for today is from the beautiful and the wonderful account of the Gospel of John, chapter 16, verses 5 to 11. Going away is sad. Going away is painful. It's a struggle. It is difficult and hard to lose someone we love, right? We have heard in today's gospel that the disciples of Jesus were filled with sorrow when he told them that he is leaving. But Jesus told them, "It is to your advantage that I go away." Jesus is leaving them, not because he don't love them, but the gospel says, it is for their advantage. And if I may rephrase the word of Jesus, maybe Jesus is telling the disciples, I'm leaving, but my absence is for your own good. Three important points that I would like to share with you this morning. Number one, today's gospel reading is a part of the farewell discourse of Jesus. And it is a preparation for the next celebration, that is the Ascension and the Pentecost. And Jesus is going back to heaven. And what's the first message that I would like to share with you today? My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, going home to God must be our greatest desire in life. Going to heaven must always be our desire, our innermost desire. And in my life, I have this shortest prayer I always pray every day. And I always pray, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. My dear friends, my dear followers, the greatest good in life is returning back to where we came from. To be in heaven is the greatest advantage in life. Desire heaven, aspire heaven, desire to be with God, desire to return in heaven. And the second point that I would like to share is this. It is hard to say goodbye. It is painful to bid farewell. That's why if you notice here in Canada, you know, people don't say goodbye. Instead, they say, see you again. You know, in one of my parishes here, in a First Nation community in Cree, they always told me, eximaga, meaning to say, see you again, or see you later, see you tomorrow, see you. We don't say goodbye. My dear friends, the gospel is teaching us today, like Jesus, learn to let go. Why? Because when we let go, we grow. There is no growth in holding. There is no progress if we don't learn the value of detachment or renunciation. Let go and you will grow. Let go, meaning to say, release those memories that gives you headaches and stress. Detach from someone that complicates or give problems or troubles in your life. Unchain your life, free your life from the bondage of inordinate attachments. It may be a relationship, it may be an addiction, or maybe a habit of weakness. Let go, because letting go is making you grow. And finally, the gospel speaks about sin, righteousness, and judgment. To be saved, we need to let go of sin. To be saved, we need to be righteous, because at the end, there is a judgment day. We will be judged at the end of our pilgrimage. Let go of sin, believe in the Lord, and be righteous. And to be righteous, it does not mean to be perfect, but putting trust to God amidst of our weakness. To be righteous means to possess the quality of being right in the eyes of God. But dear friends, be righteous and we will be saved. Believe in God, let go of sin, try to be righteous all the days of our life, and salvation will be ours. Let go, and you will grow. If you love and like this reflection, kindly share it with your friends, share it with your family, make the word of God viral so that many will be blessed. Amen.